Walk you through a mechanism. This is from the 2002 exam, and the reason why I chose this mechanism was because it's over a reaction you just learned, so hopefully you're paying attention. So one of the things you should generally do in mechanisms is to, like, before you do anything, like, first note this is a one product mechanism, so it's fairly simple. I would also characterize the product. So I would say that the product, if I had to characterize it, is alkene. Right? And then I would also, like, make note of any obvious rearrangement. So it looks like there was a ring opening. So ring opening. Like, I wouldn't do this on my test. I wouldn't write these words underneath this, but maybe off to the side, or just to help you understand what you're moving towards and what you should be generally looking for when you do these things. So, like, for alkene, you know there's going to be a step where a base attacks an adjacent proton. And in mechanism, we only do E1 or SN1, right? So if it's going to be elimination, if I'm going to form an alkene, then a base has to attack an adjacent proton. And the proton has to be adjacent to a carbocation. So I know that gives me a lot of information right there. And if I know if there's a ring opening, I know I have to move towards some type of increasing stability. I might want to consider numbering my product and things like that. So also maybe, like, if you recognize the reagent, so H2SO4. So maybe you could fall back on what you know about the reagent. So recognizing the reaction, you might know the steps for that reaction. And then finally, always remember errors flow from electron rich to electron poor. Just those general things are really important. So it is a dehydration reaction. And the first step we're going to do is we're going to protonate our alcohol. And if you're, like, confused on what to do first, I mean, just think very, like, logically. I have H2SO4. What's probably going to happen first? Well, probably H2SO4 is a very strong acid, so it's going to lose its hydrogen. And the alcohol looks like the only nucleophile available to pick up that hydrogen. So the alcohol picks up the hydrogen, H2SO4 loses it, you form HSO4-, but you also form this product. And you should recognize this since we just went over it, but you're going to form a good leaving group, which is water. So whenever you do that, you want to make sure you draw this bond so you have a really easy way to show that leaving group leaving. I'm just going to draw these as lines now. So now my water leaves. But there's one exception, and the reason why I even chose this problem was the exception in Bean's notes. She writes about primary carbons don't readily undergo dehydration. And for alcohol, for water to leave, you need to have some type of hydride shift or some type of shift at the same time that would allow this to occur. Well, I mean, I definitely would move more towards a hydride shift first, but if I, at the same time, look at what I'm moving towards a product, which is ring opening. That means, like, remember the substituent was supposed to be right here, right? But it's no longer there, meaning it was engulfed into the ring. So this would probably be the perfect opportunity to do a bond shift. So the reason why these two steps are shown together is because in Bean's notes, she makes it very clear that for a primary to lose water, a primary carbon to lose OH2, or what was formerly alcohol that got protonated, it needs to have some type of rearrangement that occurs at the same time. So that's why we're doing it like this. So whenever we do, like, a ring opening, I prefer you guys to first draw the structure as it was before any change. And the bond that you're changing or the bond that you're moving, just don't write that in until you draw the structure as it was. So CH2. And so the bond moves from this position to that position. So it was originally connected to the bridgehead point, and now it's going to connect directly to the CH2. So originally this carbon right here made a bond with the CH2, the top of this other ring, and then this carbon over here, right? So it made all these bonds. Now that same carbon, this one right here, it's called a carbon 1. Still makes that bond up there, makes the same bond to the CH2, but that's it. Oh, and yeah, it had this bond too. I forget about that one. So that's still there, but it only has, let's see, 1, 2, 3 bonds. It lost one bond, meaning that's where my carbocation ends up. So like that whole process was just to figure out where the carbocation was. So now that I know where my carbocation is, I'm going to go ahead and look up my product again. Okay, so I've successfully completed the ring opening, right? Let's see. Well, I still have to make the alkene, and I noticed that alkene is made at one of the ends as opposed to like the bridgehead point. And also I do notice that it's made with the CH3 and it's not made at the bigger side of the ring. So I know it's not made over here. I know it's made over here. And remember how I always say that rearrangements in order of increasing stability? Well, that is the case, right? So for me to like do a shift so I can move this carbocation over here, I have to show that it's in order of increasing stability. Well, remember the bridgehead position is only able to make a double bond if it has 8 or more carbons. And unfortunately, if I count around the ring, I only get 7, including this new big ring. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's not 8 or more carbons. So in order of increasing stability, doing a hydride shift and moving a carbocation from my bridgehead position to this position over here is an order of increasing stability, even though this carbon right here is a 1, 2, 3, a tertiary carbon, and I'd be moving my carbocation to another tertiary position. This tertiary position is not the bridgehead position, which is why it's more stable. So, this is one way you could write hydride shift, by the way. You could just write the words as well. So now I know that I have the carbocation at the right position. So from here, it's just really straightforward dehydration. So after you form the carbocation at the right position, you just deprotonate a adjacent hydrogen to form your alkene. And so which hydrogen do I pick? Well, I obviously can't pick the bridgehead position, right? Because that position is not stable unless I have 8 or more carbons in one of the rings and in one continuous ring. So I can't pick like the entire molecule and say like it has 8 or more carbons. I can only pick one continuous ring. So I can't count like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's not okay because I'm counting all the rings. I can only count one continuous ring and not both cyclic, like, so it's a bridge bicyclic, so I can't count either one of the bridges because technically this could be a bridge or that could be a bridge, you know. Any point that's connected to this could be a bridge from any which end. So if I counted the ring this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that's 6 carbons. That's not enough to form a double bond with the bridge head. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That's not enough to form double bonds with the rich head. So the only hydrogen that I can pick, since I can't pick this hydrogen, and this is where my carbocation is this hydrogen right here. So the base I'm going to use to deprotonate and form my alkene is the base that was formed when H2SO4 lost its proton. So it's HSO4. And I show it like this because it's easier to show the single oxygen that is negative. And it's going to pick off this proton. And that's how I generally draw my arrows. Like I draw the arrow at the point where I wanted to attack and then draw backwards. It's just easier that way. I don't know why. Form my alkene and draw my arrow straight to my product. Sort of. But I hope that was helpful. This is a really good problem where she shows, where she like tests your ability to understand Bredt's rule. At the same time, the exception to alcohols where primaries can't really form carbocations as readily without rearrangement occurring at the same time. And actually, I did notice a mistake. So over here, I didn't write the words bond shift. I totally should have wrote those words because technically without those, I don't get points. So that's about it. It's only a few steps, but it's a very